In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an outline around text using Lightburn. So the first thing we need to do is write our text. So I'm coming over to the text tool here, clicking there and then clicking on the screen. And I'm just going to type out the word welcome. Now the sorts of fonts you want to be looking at here are these sort of script fonts where everything flows together and joins. They work the best for this. So if I click on the select tool now, you can see how it's all joined. And if it's not joining for you, could be that you've got welded unselected here. If I click on it, you'll notice it's still showing as unjoined, but as soon as I click on it, it shows it as welded. Now this is where you want to make any changes to this text. So you can drag it out, make it thicker here, or you can make it bold or unbolded, whatever works for you. So this is the time to make any changes you want. Now the next thing you want to do is create an offset. So while it's selected, come over here to the offset tool, click there, and you can see how it's already added an offset around the shape here. So here in the offset distance tool, you can see you can click on the arrows to go up or down and create it thicker or thinner. So it's up to you how you want to go. I might go maybe about there or there, that's fine. And I've got outward selected and round, so I'll go okay. Now you can see here we've got this little sort of blemish here that's not really shouldn't be there. So I'm going to click on the outer shape and drag it down. Then I'm going to right click on it and click ungroup. And then I'm going to click away. And then now I can just select that and click the delete key on my keyboard to get rid of it. So that's done there. Now that's pretty much it, but there are two ways you can cut and engrave this depending on your preference. So the first way is this way. And as you can see there, we have two separate pieces and we've got the welcome text cut and also the background cut. And you can just glue them together. You can color them in different colors and glue them together. So in order to do that, what you need to do is have both of these in the same color. So I've got both of them in green. It doesn't matter what colors they are, but as long as they're both the same. And then over on the cuts and layers panel, you want to come over and select line because you want to cut both of these shapes. Then you want to double click here and just select the settings that suit your machine for cutting whatever you might be cutting. I'm cutting, I think it's 3mm MDF, and I'm using a Sculpfun S30. So my settings are 200 speed and the power will be 100. And I want air assist on. I've got air assist with my machine and I want it on when I'm cutting. So I'll click OK. And that's it. So that's how that will turn out now. It'll turn out where each piece is separated out. But if you want a different look, if you want this sort of look, where the text is engraved onto the actual wood or MDF, then what you need to do is you need to come up and click on your welcome or whatever text you've got, and then change it to another color. It doesn't matter what you change it to. And then, because we're going to be engraving this, so we need to come over here. You can see how it's separated out now. We need to create this one as a fill because it's going to engrave. And again, I'll double click on the speed and power and change my settings here. For my machine, it would be 2000 speed and 20 power. And I don't want air assist on because I'm engraving, and I'll go okay. All right. And for the line here, this part here, the outline is going to be cut. So that's exactly as it appears here. So it's going to be a line, so because it's cutting. And that's my speed and power for that. And now all we need to do is move our text over on top of our background. So I'll move that there, and just to ensure that everything's centered, just highlight everything. So I'm clicking and dragging from the right, and then I'm clicking this option up here. We'll just center everything both vertically and horizontally. Okay, so we're good to go there. And then we just need to move this up. It's always a good idea to cut or to engrave, sorry, before you cut. So I'm going to move this, the engraved part, upwards by clicking on it and clicking the little arrow on the side here. So that moves it up. So now it's going to engrave first and then it will cut. Okay, so that's it. So thank you for watching, and please give us a big thumbs up if you can. That really helps our channel. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this.